Are you a scientist or engineer who's about to finish up a graduate degree and you are trying to decide between a career in academia or a career in industry? In nearly 10 years of mentoring scientists and engineers in their career choices, I found most people tend to be better suited for one than the other. So in this video, I'll give you three questions to help you decide if you should stay in academia or transition into a career in industry. Hey everybody, Dave Giltner with TurningScience. It's been several months since my last video. I've been on a lot of travel teaching two new workshops, and it's been going great, but I realize I've gotten really behind in making videos. So here is the next one. Now, the upside of all that travel is I've gotten to spend a lot of time with many of you and understand some of your biggest concerns about your careers. And I'm going to be working those ideas into my next several videos. One of the biggest concerns that we scientists and engineers face as we finish up our graduate degrees is, do we stay in academia or do we transition into the private sector? This can be a really tough decision for a lot of people. Some of the questions that make it seem so ominous are, will I like working in industry? If I stay in academia, am I going to end up only writing proposals all the time and not really doing any interesting work? If I transition into industry, will I lose my freedom to do work that I really enjoy, things that excite me? If I go into industry, can I change if I find that I don't like it? These are some really tough questions, and it can be a hard decision for a lot of people. So in this video, I'm going to give you three questions that will really help you decide which is best for you. And if you are already looking for a job, I have something that will really help you there as well. So stick around to the end of the video, and I'll tell you about that also. Question number one, are you interested in the applications for the research you're doing? Do you find yourself frequently wondering, what will this be used for? Who will ultimately use the research that I'm working on? If you do, you should definitely consider a career in industry, because that's what industry is all about. Identifying and creating applications for the awesome science research that is done in academia. I find that some people really like to study science for its own sake, and that's great. Others, though, really care a lot about what their work will be used for. Some research, of course, doesn't really find applications for years or even decades, and that's okay. But some people don't like spending a lot of time on their work and not knowing what it's going to turn into, who is going to need it, what it's ultimately going to be used for. Think about two ends of this spectrum. On one side, you're studying a problem that will help us better understand the universe. You're creating new knowledge, new science, but it's not really clear what it will be used for. It might not even be clear how many people in the world care about this problem right now. On the other end of the spectrum, there's a very clear need and you are trying to address it. It could be anything from a new scientific instrument to trying to improve the speed of optical communications to trying to cure cancer. But whatever it is, when you get up and you go into work in the morning, you know exactly where your work is headed. You know exactly the problem you're trying to solve and who needs your work. If you think about this spectrum and you find yourself much more closely associated with this end of the spectrum, with the application, you should definitely consider a career in industry. Question number two, do you like variety in your work environment or do you prefer consistency? Would you be okay having a new project to work on every year or two or maybe even every 6 months? Or would you prefer to work on one or two research areas over many years, developing a deeper knowledge, a deeper understanding, and a greater expertise over time? If you prefer the variety, I would definitely suggest you consider a career in industry. Industry tends to be more dynamic than academic research. Companies need to change to keep up with changing markets or competition or simply to grow the company. Now that's something I found to be a really exciting part of my own industry career. I get bored a bit easily, I like new challenges, I love to learn new things, and my industry career has given me many chances to do that on a regular basis. So as an example, early in my career, I worked for a fairly small laser company. It was about 500 people. And I was in a group that was developing a number of new technologies, trying to find one or two that would have a larger commercial success. And that meant over a few years, I got to work on a lot of different projects. And I found it really, really exciting. I like that variety. Academic research tends not to change so much. It tends to be more stable. So if you like the variety, I would definitely consider a career in industry. Question number three, is work-life balance important to you? If so, you should probably consider a career in industry. Generally speaking, people who work in industry have more time for life outside of their work. Now, I have a theory on this. Academic research tends to be pretty open-ended. You can always understand the problem better, collect more data, do more analysis, have more publications, But in industry, you tend to be working towards very specific results, which usually result in shipping something to a customer. And as long as you're getting those results, or as long as your plan shows you were on track to get those results on time, you can go home. Now, I remember when I was working on my PhD, academic research, the results I was after were really far in the future. The only real measure of my success seemed to be the effort that I was putting in, how long I spent in the lab. That's what people could see. That's what my advisor could see. And I felt like the longer I spent in the lab, the better I was doing. Ever since I've worked in industry, I've had very specific results that I was trying to achieve. It was very clear what was expected from me that week, that month, or that year. And as long as I was achieving those results, or I was hitting specific milestones on schedule, I felt fine going home. I was being measured by my results, not by the amount of effort I put in. And if I found a way to get those results quicker or more efficiently, that was a bonus. That helped me. Now, it's not like you don't hear about entrepreneurs, people in startups working day and night to get their companies off the ground. Absolutely, you do. So some of that certainly happens. But generally speaking, people in industry have more time for life outside of their work. Trying to decide between a career in academia or a career in industry can be rather challenging. Much of the uncertainty stems from you're trying to make a decision between something you understand well, academia, and something you probably don't understand very well at all, industry. And if you're still struggling with this, if you're still feeling uncertain, make an effort to do informational interviews, or some people call them expert interviews, with people who work in industry. Ask them what they like about their careers, what excites them, what they find challenging, what they don't really like about it. This is something that will really help you quite a bit, help that uncertainty. Now, I mentioned earlier, I have something extra for those of you who are already looking for a job. I recently completed my Essential Industry Job Search Guide for Scientists, and I'd like to get it to you for free. Just look for the link in the description below this video that says Essential Job Search Guide. Now, I'm sure you're aware there's a lot of job search advice out there. The thing is, most of that has been created by people who make a career of giving job search advice, not by people who have actually worked in industry, spent a career there, know what industry managers, hiring managers are looking for, and know how industry works. I do, and that's what I've put in this guide. I talk about what a manager in industry would like to see in your resume, about how you can talk about your academic research in a way that makes them take notice, and even about how you can sound like you understand how industry works, even if you don't have any industry experience, if you've never worked there. If you want to get this great guide, just check out the link in the description below, Essential Job Search Guide. Check it out. You'll be glad you did. Well, I hope you found this video on making that decision between an academic career and an industry career helpful. If you like this video, please click that like icon below. It'll help me, but more importantly, you will help other people who could benefit from this video because more likes means YouTube shows it to more people. I'd also be grateful if you'd share this video with your friends and your colleagues. And if you'd like to get more videos like this yourself, click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. I try to make about 2 of these every month to help you build the career you really want. Thanks for watching. Now let's get out there and turn science into things people need.